Hey guys, I'm coming on here to do a third and fourth month Accutane update. I am actually finished with my fourth month now, a little bit over 4 months, like 4 days over 4 months. So I'm going to go ahead and do an update just to let you guys know some changes that have happened during this time. First, let's start off with my progress. I'm gonna go ahead and roll that clip now. My doctor decided to try to wean me off or to slowly taper me off of Accutane. I didn't feel confident or I didn't feel comfortable with it. I felt like my skin was still having new breakouts, so I didn't think I was ready to be coming off of Accutane. But she changed me from 20 milligrams to 10 milligrams a day. And I guess because of like my concern with this decision, she told me to come back in 2 weeks just to see how my face is reacting or how my skin has changed from coming from 20 milligrams to 10 milligrams. And during the time that I was on 10 milligrams for just 2 weeks, my skin did change a lot. Like I was just getting bigger breakouts. So I had already been having new breakouts before she changed me to the 10 milligrams, but during those 2 weeks that I was on the 10 milligrams, I was having like bigger pimples coming through. So I knew that that meant I wasn't ready to come off of Accutane. So when I went back to her, she looked at my skin and she said that she would still like me to stay on only 10 milligrams, but she went ahead and put me on 20 milligrams because of me just asking for it, I guess. Now with her, I completely understand what she was saying. She really just doesn't like to have her patients on Accutane for such a long period of time, which is very different from the States. I've heard that in the States that people are on Accutane for up to 6 months and sometimes even more. They are also on a higher dose of Accutane. So it's really different from the States, but here they like to keep you on a really low dose of Accutane and they want to cut it as short as possible. So as soon as they see some progress in your skin, they want to try to start tapering you off of Accutane. Before she lowered my dose to 10 milligrams, she kept saying that my skin looks much better than it did before, and I completely agreed with her, but I honestly was hoping to have like really clear skin to where I wouldn't have to worry about acne or worry about like any breakouts for at least a few months. But with her, it was more like, let's just make your skin better and then get you off of Accutane. So that's why she was so adamant on me getting off of Accutane. If you're in Korea and you feel that you are kind of going through the same situation where your doctor is trying to rush you off of Accutane, but you still want to stay on it to have even clearer skin, I would say to just keep kind of pushing the idea. If you have an older, and definitely if you have an older male doctor, it might not work as well as my situation because I do have a younger female doctor. So she was really patient with me and listened to me, and I think she kind of understands what, you know, I want and where I'm coming from. But from my experience at least, if I have an older male doctor, they tend to not really listen to the patients. So if you are experiencing something like this, I would just say to try your best to convince them to let you stay on it just a little bit longer. That's only if you feel comfortable with it as well. Like if you're having suicidal thoughts or if your skin is like cracking and bleeding, it's not worth it. You should listen to your doctor and just get off of Accutane. So that was basically month three. Not much had changed between month two and month three other than me switching from 20 milligrams to 10 milligrams for 2 weeks. Other than that, same dry lips, my skin has been pretty good. Like, I haven't had any flaking or anything. Just my skin feels pretty normal. My lips are the only thing that's just like really dry. And I think that's because of the weather too. It is just cold. It is so cold here. They're saying that it's like one of the coldest days in like Daegu's history or something like that. It's pretty ridiculous. All right, so moving to month four, when she changed me to 20 milligrams, I kind of went through like the purging cycle again, where I just broke out pretty bad around my chin and cheek area, and I had like the biggest, nastiest, I didn't even take a picture of it because it's just nasty, but I had the biggest, nastiest cystic pimple right here on my ear. Like, it was gross. So I kind of left it alone for a while. My hair was straight at the time, so whenever my hair is flat iron, I wear it down basically every day. So it was covering it up good, but it got to the point where it was just so huge and nasty that I had to pop it. Like, I had to just pop it and get rid of it. So once I popped it, it was good though. It just kind of like deflated and went away. And I don't feel like any kind of bump or anything there now. Maybe there's a scar that I can't see, but I just had to get rid of it. Since being on the 20 milligrams though, this month, I have definitely felt like I've hit a plateau. My skin does not seem to be getting worse, but I don't feel that it's getting better either. So I just constantly have breakouts throughout here. It's nothing that serious, but it's still acne that I don't want on my face. And I feel like with me being on Accutane that I shouldn't be having these breakouts down here. Now, I don't know if I just kind of took, you know, 10 steps back when she put me on the 10 milligrams. So maybe within the next month or so, these will start going away. I've had these pimples for a while now. They don't seem to be getting better. Like, popping them, like, they're not even like popping, like coming out, you know what I mean? So I don't know. So she suggested that I get laser extraction, and I told her I don't think I'm gonna do that right now just because of money. Because this, when it's like this kind of thing, it's a lot cheaper than in the States still, but something like this will cost me like 75,000 won or maybe 80,000 won, and I'm just not really trying to spend that much right now on my skin, especially because I have a vacation coming up soon. I did ask her if I continue to just keep using Accutane, will it eventually go away? And she explained that Accutane is mostly used to prevent new pimples from coming. These are pimples that have already like exposed themselves. So if they're not, you know, coming out of my body on their own, then I probably need to go ahead and do the laser extraction to get rid of them. I don't know, I have some time to think about it though. Right now it's January, or like the end of January, and I don't have to make my next appointment until March, she said. So I have a little over a month. I think by March I'll be able to make my decision though, because if by March these pimples are still kind of hanging around, then I think that's when I'll know that, yeah, they need to just go ahead and be removed because they're not coming out on their own. One more thing I want to mention real quick before I end this video. I did have a viewer ask me if the Accutane is helping with my acne scars. Now, I'm not really 100% sure if Accutane is supposed to help with scars or not, but what I feel that is helping with my acne scars is Epiduo. So I am using Epiduo while taking Accutane. And Epiduo is basically a Retin-A gel, and usually when you finish your Accutane routine, the dermatologist will prescribe a Retin-A cream to help with the acne scarring. I have been on Epiduo for my entire Accutane journey. Maybe it is this that's helping. Maybe it's a combination of the Accutane and the Epiduo gel, because Accutane does kind of make your skin thinner. So maybe because of that, the Epiduo is able to do its job. I don't really know, but my best guess is that the Epiduo is what's helping with my scarring. One more thing I forgot to mention about using Accutane is feeling depressed. I still don't believe I feel depressed or have any type of, well, I know I haven't had any type of suicidal thoughts. The one thing I will say that I have noticed is being a little moody. And I'm not saying just like, I'm not saying like extreme, like angry moodiness. It's more so not wanting to do anything. So I'll just be like, I'm just gonna sit in front of the TV and watch Blacklist and eat some ice cream or something like that. Like that's the kind of moods I get into. Now, I don't know if it has anything to do with Accutane or if it's just me being straight lazy, but I have definitely noticed that I've had more situations like that. Overall, I am a very happy person. I do feel great most days, but I do just have those off days where I'm just like,
leave me alone.
All right, so that is all I have to say about month 3 and 4 on Accutane. It's been pretty smooth journey. We'll see what happens within the next month with these pimples that are kind of on my chin and cheek area. If they don't clear up by March, then I might have to go ahead and dish out some cash for that laser extraction, but I don't know, we'll see. I will keep you guys posted and go ahead and subscribe if you're interested in seeing the rest of my Accutane journey and any other videos that I post up about living in Korea, being tall, being half black and half Korean, food, my travels, whatever I want to make a video about. All right, you guys take care. See you in my next video. Bye. Hey guys, today I'm going to talk about 5 things that are cheaper in Korea and I'm comparing them to America. Number 5 is transportation. And what I'm referring to when I say transportation is public transportation.